How's it going, everyone? Welcome to another video. I'm very excited for this video. It's gonna be awesome. By the way, got a new haircut, especially for you guys and for myself. It was much needed. Hope you guys like it. You can let me know if you like the shorter haircut or the flow better. You guys can just let me know for that. But today, I'm very excited. We are gonna be doing the What's in My Baseball Bag video. I'm gonna go through all my equipment, hopefully, give you guys some pointers to what sort of equipment you guys might want. And so yeah, let's get into the video. So guys, how this is gonna work, I don't really have like a specific order, but basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with like the smaller accessories in my bag, and then I'm gonna move up to like the more important equipment part. Alright guys, the first accessory that I carry in my bag, and I really recommend you guys do as well, is a weighted ball. This is perfect for anything, for throwing, even if you're not a pitcher, or even for just hitting it off the tee. I did that sometimes. I actually got this with the hitting net that I ordered during quarantine so I could hit in my backyard, so I really recommend you guys have this in your bag. The next type of ball I suggest you guys have and that I have in my bag is actually a baseball stress ball. I mean, you can have really any stress ball, but my mom got me this during Christmas and I just thought it was really cool because it's a baseball. But you know what? Baseball is a high stress sport, so if you have one of these, you know, it might actually help you quite a bit. Alright guys, the next accessory I recommend you guys have in your bag, and which I carry, is a rosin bag. I know you guys have probably heard that rosin bags are really just for pitchers, but I recommend anyone, no matter what position you play, you have one of these. I mean, you always play baseball in like wet weather, so I mean the grass could be wet, whatever it is. And as an infielder, outfielder, even a catcher, having one of these in your back pocket, it could save you a lot of missed throws or any errors. Like, I really recommend you guys have one of these. Alright guys, the next accessory that's probably the most vital of all of them to have, as obvious as it may be, are sunglasses. Sunglasses are so important as any baseball player, because when you play during the day, the sun is really bright. Like, you really need sunglasses a lot. You don't need to buy like these, like Oakleys, which are probably pretty expensive. As long as they do their job, they're perfect. So I really recommend you guys get a pair. Alright guys, the two accessories that I really recommend you guys have are a arm sleeve and a elbow guard. So first, the arm sleeve. This is very new for me. This will be the first year I've ever played with one, but as like most people get them because of course they look really cool, but honestly, I've also heard that it really helps with like arm care, and me personally, I do get sore arms quite a bit. So I decided to get one, and I got blue because it's my favorite color and it matches my team. So I'll let you guys know if I really think it's worth it, but right now I think it is. And the second accessory is a elbow guard. I recommend you get either an elbow guard or a shin guard. I really only recommend this if you've gotten hit there before because it will really protect it. I got hit in the elbow a couple years ago, so I started wearing this. But yeah, if you've ever gotten hit in the elbow or the shin, I definitely recommend you guys get an Evo Shield guard. Alright guys, I just talked about the arm sleeve, and speaking of arm care, another accessory you guys should really have in your bag are J-bands. These things, do them before and after you throw. They're great for building strength and they're just great for arm care. They really keep your arm healthy. These, I don't believe they sell these in Canada, so you might have to order it online, but it will be pretty much the greatest investment you guys ever made. Like, it is very useful. It will keep you guys in the game longer. So yeah, I really recommend you guys get some J-bands. Alright guys, that concluded the accessories part of the video. Now we're gonna hop right into all the equipment I use, starting with my cleats. And personally, cleats are very hard for me to find because I have massive feet. I'm size 14 right now. So you guys will probably have an easier time trying to get those. But first, I'll hop into my metal cleats, and then I'll show you guys my turf cleats. So my metal cleats, I use these blue and white New Balance cleats. Size 14, as I said. I love New Balance. They're my favorite brand of cleat for metal, especially. I've worn them my whole life, so I really recommend you guys have that brand as well. And for my turf cleats, when I go down to the US, I use these black and white Mizunos. Mizuno and Nike have been the two brands I use for my turf cleats. I think they're probably the two best. They're also the two that have my size. But yeah, those are the two pairs of cleats I use the most. So before I show you guys the gloves I use, I'll just show you my helmet quickly. It's not something I really get to choose. It's the team helmets that they buy. So this is the helmet that I have with my number at the back. This is a Rawlings helmet, I believe, and I really love Rawlings helmets. So if you do have the opportunity to actually get a helmet, Rawlings is probably what I'd recommend. But yeah, the two gloves I use, so I'm a first baseman primarily. So for my first baseman's glove, I use a Mizuno, and it is blue and red. And I've had this glove, I think, for about 3 years. And I might have to get a new one soon because it's very floppy now, but I really love this glove so much. The only comment I would have about it that's negative would be that for the Mizuno first baseman's glove, the pockets are a little small. And as a first baseman, of course, the bigger the pocket, the better. But otherwise, Mizuno first baseman's gloves are really good, so I'd really recommend them to you guys. And this is a 12.5 inch. And just in case I ever play another position during a game, I probably my secondary position would be third base. I also bought this glove, which you can pretty much use anywhere. It is a blue Rawlings, and it is 11.75 inch glove. You've also got a cool little picture in there. I don't know if you can see it. It's of a bull, and it says Heart of the Hide, so I just thought that was pretty cool as well. And yeah, blue to match my team color. So yeah, this is the glove I use for any other position but first base. And finally, I have saved the best for last, so I really hope you've made it this far, and it is the bats I use. So I'm going to show you guys one wood bat that I use, and then a BB Corps bat that I use. So wood bats are more for the US, and BB Corps bats are what I use here in Canada. So for my wood bat, I use the Marucci Kutch 22 Pro model, Kutch for Andrew McCutcheon. This is actually a 34 inch, but I swing a 33 normally. The only reason I bought this was because this was the last bat they had in stock and it was a 34, so I thought, you know what, better to be longer than shorter, I can just choke up. But this is by far the best bat, wood bat, I've ever used in my life. And it has crazy pop, it feels absolutely amazing. And the best part, it was actually fairly cheap for a baseball bat. This was $180, I believe, which, trust me, if you don't know baseball bats, it is very cheap. And lastly, guys, my BB Corps bat. So, I just got this new, just like the wood bat I just showed you. This year, I'll be using the Easton Alpha 360. So far, when I've used this bat, it has incredible pop. I actually did some research on it, and they said that they actually designed the barrel of this bat thinner to give it like a trampoline effect. And I mean, I don't know about you guys, but a trampoline effect on a bat, it sounds like a lot of home runs, and I can guarantee you from the BP I've taken from it, they're right. But yeah, so that is the BB Corps bat I will be using this year, and it is a very good bat, the Easton Alpha 360. But yeah, guys, that's going to conclude the video today. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys are new to the channel, please subscribe down below. It would really help me a lot. And also, make sure to go back and watch the two videos before this, my introduction video to this channel and my day in the life video. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it a lot, and I will see you guys in the next video.